about your language and how you approached the coronavirus at the beginning. I interviewed someone who said that his family got sick. They went to a funeral in mid-March. And they said mainly because the president wasn't taking it seriously. He said, if the president had had a mask on, if he was saying we should stay home, then I would have stayed home.
Well,
instead,
I have family members.
He said his family members were sick and because they were listening to you. Do you feel like, or are you concerned that downplaying the virus maybe got some people sick?
And a lot of people love Trump, right? A lot of people love him. You see him all the time, right? I guess I'm here for a reason, you know? To the best of my knowledge, I won. And I think we're going to win again. I think we're going to win in a landslide. But just so you understand, you're talking about March, right?
Yeah.
And yet, excuse me. I know. I understand. And yet in January, a certain date, you know the date better than I do, we put on a ban of China, where China can't come in. And before March, we put on a ban on Europe, where Europe can't come in. So how could you say I wasn't taking it seriously? Do you know, I put on a ban on China before anybody in this country died. I put on a ban. And so you tell me, Nancy Pelosi was having, she wanted to have a street party in Chinatown in San Francisco at the end of February. That's a month later. And then they tell me, it's only a political talking point, but you feed into it because you're too good a reporter to let that happen. Really, you are a good reporter. You're too good a reporter to let that happen. Remember this. So at the end of January, I put on a ban. People that were in that room will tell you that I think there were 21 people. I was the only one in the whole room that wanted to do it. Fortunately, I was the one that counted for that purpose. We put on a ban because I was reading bad things about China. World Health Organization should have told us. But I was reading it with or without them. They should have known. All they had to do is read it. They didn't have to even be there. But they tried to cover up for China. World Health covered up for China. But no, wait, but you can't say this. Look, I put on a ban. In other words, I stopped China from coming to the United States. I stopped Europe from coming into the United States long before the March date that you're talking about. So people should say I acted very early. That was a very hard thing to do. Doing that was a very hard thing. I didn't want to do that, but I did it because I thought, and Dr. Fauci said that by doing it, President Trump saved tens of thousands of lives. So I did take it very seriously.
You held rallies in February and in March, and there are some Americans.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know about rallies. I really don't know about rallies. I know one thing.
In February.
I haven't left the White House in months, except for a brief moment to give a wonderful ship the comfort.
You held a rally in March.
I don't know. Did I hold a rally? I'm sorry. I hold a rally. Did I hold a rally? Let me tell you, in January, when I did this, yet virtually no cases and no deaths, and yet I put it on. So how could I not? Why was Nancy Pelosi, right? Nancy Pelosi is holding a street fair. She wants a street fair in San Francisco in Chinatown to prove, you know what the purpose of it was, to prove that there's no problem. Many other politicians did the same thing and wanted to prove. Yeah. While I was, no, of course not. No. People are amazed at how early I acted, and I did act early. With that being said, it's very hard to say, let's close down the greatest economy in the history of the world. I had to close down, I and everybody else that works with me, and close to 350 million people built the greatest economy in the history of the world. Best employment numbers, best stock market numbers, best numbers in virtually every category, even good manufacturing numbers. The previous administration said manufacturing was dead for our country. Even great manufacturing numbers. And you know what? I did that, and somebody walked into my office and said, sir, you're going to have to close down the economy. You're going to have to close the country. But you know what I say to you? We're going to rebuild it, and we're going to rebuild it better, and it's going to go faster than people think. I built it once. I'll build it a second time. Please.